this feeling inside my bones. It goes electric, wavy when I turn it on. All through my city, all through my home. We're flying up, no ceiling when we in our zone. I got that sunshine in my pocket, got that good soul in my feet. I feel that hot blood in my body when it drops. Ooh, I can't take my eyes off of it, moving so phenomenally. You're more like the way we rock it, so don't stop.
Dads, mentors, and male role models make a huge difference in a child's life. The children of men who participate in father involvement programs like All Pro Dad have improved grades, better behavior, and according to Futures Without Violence, a more stable home life with decreased odds of domestic violence. For more than 20 years, All Pro Dad has created opportunities for men to be with their kids, engage with their kids, show them and tell them why they're proud of them and how much they love them. For 1 hour a month, dads and kids meet with other All Pro Dads and their children. Kids love it, and they realize what's important to my dad is me. That's why the All Pro Dad program matters. Because men matter, dads matter, you matter. We're glad you want to explore how you can make a difference for dads and kids and your own child by being a team captain.
So hi, dads and kids, and welcome to the first ever national All Pro Dad chapter event. Whether you're experiencing the All Pro Dad chapter for the first time or you've been a part of a chapter for years, we are very excited that you have taken the time to invest in your relationships with each other. We are going to have a great time this evening. Over 600 families have registered to join you for the fun. So we're super thankful for our over 1,300 team captains out there who work to provide dads and male role models and their kids a chance to create deeper relationships through the experience of the All Pro Dad chapter. We are thankful for our members that bring their children to the school chapter and now to the new and improved virtual chapter experience. Together, we as a bunch make up a rapidly growing number of families who are working to love each other each day through All Pro Dad. So dads, to make sure that you're ready to go for this experience, please find the chat button at the bottom of your screen or on your mobile device so that you're able to share your pride points about your kid during the upcoming pride moment and your child's comments during our group conversation and discussion times. You'll also use the chat feature to ask any questions that you might have about this evening or our program in general. We'll be following up with you after this event to make sure we have supported you with all the All Pro Dad materials that you need to be the best dad you can be. So we actually have a full team that supports the All Pro Dad chapters, and we have some of them on tonight to help support you. So Wendy's our national support leader. Keith is actually our national chapter developer in Georgia, South Carolina, and the southern part of the U.S. Paul is our national chapter developer for a part of Florida, and he's also one of three regional team captains in Florida. Dan is actually in special projects for our All Pro Dad in Florida, and CJ is our support specialist for special events just like this one and partnerships that we have with large organizations and companies. Christian's actually a developer for all of Florida and the north and the western part of the United States. And I'm your host and the other Keith and the All Pro Dad Chapters Development Manager responsible for global expansion of All Pro Dad Chapters. So let's start our time together tonight by celebrating our kids to our kids directly and share that with one another. So tonight we're extremely honored to have with us the co-founder and spokesperson for All Pro Dad. He's an NFL Hall of Fame coach, Coach Tony Dungy. He's with us tonight from his home with his kids, and we're so excited to have him.
Hello, Keith. How are you?
Hey, Can Coach. You yes, Coach. We've got you. Thank you so much for being here tonight with your kiddos.
All righty. Well, it is awesome being here. As you mentioned, 1999, 1998, I got involved with All Pro Dad here in Tampa, and it was just fantastic to be part of it and watch it grow. And one of the things that has been so neat has been these All Pro Dad, normally they're breakfast in the morning and we're at school. And this, I'll have to say, I've been to quite a few of those, but this is my first one virtually with people from all over the country. So it's great to be here. I have two of our kids with us, and we normally do this at Carrollwood Day School here in Tampa, but we're doing it from our kitchen tonight. And this is Jason, who is 9 years old. And this is Jalen, who is, 10. Jason is 10, Jalen is 7. 8. Okay. COVID has got me behind the scenes on these birthdays, but they're all doing great. And one of the neat things, and probably the most exciting thing about an All-Pro Dad meeting, is the pride moment. And we kind of want to explain how that works and show you how it's done. At the beginning, the host will ask you, the captain will ask you to get up and talk about your child or children and say what you're proud about and how they have just made you proud of them. And it's not something necessarily they've done, but it's being proud of who they are. So if I was called on, I would get up at the beginning of the meeting and say, this is my son, Jason. And Jason, I'm so proud of you because during this COVID experience, when we've been at home, you've had to be a leader in the group. You've had to look out for your younger siblings and you've had to lead them. And you've done a great job of that, watching over them and being a role model. And I'm proud of you for that. And then I would turn to Jalen and say, Jalen, I'm so proud of you. We were at a birthday party and one of the parents told me that their child was so happy to be in your class. And the fact that you look out for her, you enjoy her, and you're funny and you're upbeat and you always welcome all the other kids. So I'm proud of you for being a leader in your class and doing everything to make other people feel good. So that's what a pride moment is. And everyone would go around the table and do that and say what they're proud of about their kids. So we're gonna give you the opportunity to do that right now. Take your moment, introduce your child, talk about why you're proud of them and let them respond. And while you're doing that, feel free to go into the chat room and write down what you're proud about and let us know. And also write down your children's comments or reactions and how they feel. That'll help all of us out. But thank you for being here. Thanks for taking part in this tonight. And take this moment now to let us know why you're proud of your kids.
Thanks, Coach. Okay, guys, it's your turn. Okay. Wow. Oh my gosh. There's such great news here. So Cameron, talking proud of his son, gets up early and tackles his homework Monday through Thursday at home. That's phenomenal. Way to go. All right. Let's see here.
How about Destiny James? She's really growing up and being a great leader. She has a baby sister. Wow. And great help to mom. Yeah, that's big.
All right, Janelle and Lewis writing, I'm super proud of our daughter for taking on her homeschool work this last week without anyone's help. This is a big deal. Super true.
Darren Rakert's proud of his 4 kids. They moved from Illinois to Florida and lived their lives in Illinois. Been through a hurricane now. Whew, and a pandemic.
Wow.
Yeah, they're super.
Oh my gosh. Bradley Williams proud of Marliana for staying focused on her education during the stay at home during COVID-19. Fantastic. A lot of education going on here.
How about Kinley Pagano, who is getting her schoolwork done every morning? We all got to do that.
Yeah, absolutely. Okay, let's see. So Christian, of course, loving his sons and so proud of them, learning so much right now. It's 3 boys in a small spot. Great job.
How about John Donaldson? I'm just proud of him, but he's proud of his son too.
Absolutely. Fantastic. Scotty Burke, proud of Caden because of how she treats her little sister, Cameron. Good job. Let's see, Josh has got Chloe. I'm proud of you because you're patient and kind, even when the situation is stressful. Boy, don't we need that nowadays. Woo.
Yeah, yeah. Well, how about Hannah Warboys, who's brought her grades up from Bucky? Great.
Good job. Oh, good stuff. Good stuff. And let's see, last but not least, Brian Fortreed. Daughter Miriam has been a great support for us while staying home during the quarantine, especially helping out without complaining. That was in all caps. You see that, Keith? All caps.
Yeah, I see that.
With our two foster kids, we could not do this without her. Guys, this is fantastic. Great job on encouraging your kids and posting the comments that you shared about how great they are. Taking time to regularly share your appreciation of their growth makes a profound impact on kids' lives. So keep it up, dads. All right, so Keith, lead us on.
Hey, thanks, Keith. Yeah, I'm the other Keith, one of the other Keiths. But we're so glad that Coach could be here with us tonight and lead by example. Hi, everyone. My name's Keith Shoemaker. I'm a former team captain, and now I'm very proud to be a part of the All-Pro Dad National staff. You know, we've worked very hard to keep the All-Pro Dad virtual chapter meeting as close as possible to what you would experience at a regular chapter meeting at your school. So we're keeping with the regularly scheduled curriculum topic for the month of April. The topic for our chapter meeting is forgiveness. Now, dads, get ready to post your child's answer on the chat. Get your fingers on the keyboard. Are you ready? Okay, so let me ask the kids in our group. This is our shout it out. What does it mean to forgive? Dads, put your answers in chat and go.
All right. Oh, yep. Okay.
I can't catch up here.
I'm telling you. Oh my gosh. There we go. Oh, wow. And they're pounding in. These comments are pounding in. Oh, there we go. Oh, golly. Okay. This is actually the computer can't even keep up. Yeah. All right. A lot of pride moments. Okay. To accept apologies. So John shared with that, Ken Armstrong, it's to accept an apology from someone, to no longer be angry and resentful. Keith, you got some?
Oh, I saw this one coming a long time ago. It said to let it go like Elsa. Let it go.
Oh, that's a song. Yeah. Right. Yeah. There you go. Yeah.
The dads can sing it probably.
Nice.
Yeah. To accept apologies. Great. To no longer be angry and resentful.
Oh, keep calm and not be be mean in return. That's a hard time. That's awesome. Fantastic. Troy Wingler, give someone grace. Fantastic. That's good stuff. All right.
Pay back somebody for what they did to you. Ooh.
That's Brian good- Tristan. Yep, absolutely. To let go of anger, frustration, and negative thoughts against each other. You know, that's so important because it just hurts you. That's so good.
Wow. Well, thank you for those interesting answers. So, just like at a normal chapter meeting, we're going to have a short video. Some of you might recognize this. So let's think about what forgiveness looks like.
None shall pass the secret troll bridge.
Troll bridge? I thought it was toll bridge. Look, Phyllis, I don't want any trouble.
We are guardians of the secret.
What? It's my turn to give the ominous warning, blockhead.
It's not.
It's two.
It's not.
It's two.
Not.
It's two.
You did it last time.
That was over 300 years ago.
Oh, go ahead.
We are guardians of the secret bridge. Beat it before we grind your bones to make our bed.
Bread.
What?
The expression is grind your bones to make our bread, not bed.
Oh, really? Who would want to make bread out of bones? It might break a tooth.
Well, who'd want to sleep in a bed made of bones? Sword on the back and put a crick in your neck, you knucklehead.
Ixnay in front of the ictim vey. Gravel for brain.
Fuzz face.
Thimble head. Stinky breath. Googly eyes. Waxy ears. Unibrow.
Excuse me? I need to get through. Do you have any idea what I've been through to get here? I almost got attacked by bugs and bats and got blown all over the place by the wind and almost starved to death to find a mirror that grants one last wish, which I wouldn't have even needed if Terrence had taken his time finding me a sharp thingy instead of making me break the moonstone, and then didn't even share his pixie dust because he cares more about the stupid rules than he does about me. And
hang on. Who's Terrence?
Is he a friend of yours?
Well, yeah. He was my best friend.
You're not very nice.
Hey, don't you judge me. You've been yelling at each other since I got here.
Oh, but he knows I don't mean it, don't you?
You're softy.
Like when I call you Wartface.
Yes. Oh, when I call you Big Nose.
Yeah. Booger Breath.
Stinky Pete.
Weasel Toes.
Badger Brain.
Garden Gnome.
Garden Gnome.
Oh, dear, I don't know where that came from. I crossed the line.
Say the magic words. Go on.
I'm sorry.
Do you mean it?
Oh, absolutely.
Do you feel it?
Deeply.
Well then, I forgive you.
Friends?
Friends. Your buddy.
Pal.
Amigo.
Compadre.
Oh, you're the best.
I know you.
All right, dads and kids. So think about what you saw. And let's talk about it. So our next item up would be our group questions. So now we're going to talk about how did, and you can make your answers in the chat just like you did for previously. How did one of the trolls get hurt? Thank you, Ryan. Yep, words. Yeah, calling the other troll a name. Went all the way to Garden Gnome. That was, whoo, that's rough.
Wow.
All right, hearing from Mark Kraus and who else? They're going so fast. Wow. Hector Gonzalez. Thanks.
Ryan Fortreed, someone crosses the line and hurts their feelings. Absolutely. Wherever that line might be.
All right, so next, why was it important for the troll to say the magic words and feel it?
Mike Klein, to be heartfelt. There you go.
Wow, this is great. They're coming in so fast, I can barely read them.
Yep. Jack Oswald, sincerity. Bradley Williams, he needed to be to mean what he said. Absolutely.
Garrick Yankee, because he hurt his feelings.
Yep, Tim Payne, you know, he was truly sorry. Yeah, absolutely. That's, we need that genuineness to make sure that forgiveness really happens. Absolutely.
Yeah, so he could move forward. There's a good one. All right. Yep. So what happened when one troll forgave the other troll? Yeah, they hugged each other.
That's right.
Yeah, they violated social distancing rules.
Yeah, right. Micah said they hugged and became friends again, right? Because you returned back to being friends. You bet.
Great job.
All right.
Hugged. He accepted the apology. Yeah, no longer we're fighting. That's Michael Turpin.
Absolutely. Super important part of forgiveness is accepting that, you know, and moving forward. That's super cool.
Yeah, Jason Hood said their relationship got stronger. That's a good one.
There you go.
All right.
No COVID in a fairy world. Absolutely, Brian. Thanks. That's great.
Put a little fairy dust on it. It'll all be all right. There you go.
Sure.
All right. So let's move right along. And we're going to go into our dad and quick kid questions. Now, this is between you and your kid. We're going to have this conversation. You can ask these questions and get those answers. So this is on you guys. Let me say it all. All right, guys. Thank you for sharing. That is awesome.
Super cool.
Great posts. They're still coming in. This is just, and this is awesome. Okay. So now we're going to move into our activity. Here's the, what would you do? All right. So what would you do if your classmate breaks your favorite toy, but wants to apologize? What would you do?
Wow. That's a toughie. Oof. Toys. I like my toys. That could be hard. Oh, Chris Maxey.
Comments that are coming in. We're getting some good stuff.
Yeah. Chris Maxey, accept. Yeah, accept the apology. Absolutely. Let's see.
Michael Cowan, forgive them?
Yeah.
Talk it out. Yeah. That's a good one.
Brian Lydia, give me a few minutes. That's good.
Yeah, a lot of times, a problem might be just a simple misunderstanding you got to talk about.
So true. So true. Get mad in my head, but say it's okay. So given a second on the inside, right? Okay. Sometimes it takes that when you can't go anywhere and can't walk it out. Sure.
Yeah. I'm always a little mad in my head anyway.
Annie says, thank you for apologizing and I forgive you. That's great. Fantastic.
All right. Okay. Here's the next one. Your sibling ate the last cookie and doesn't share with you.
Like the last?
The last cookie.
Oh.
Yeah. Now me, I'm going to go make more cookies.
Oh, my gosh.
That's just me.
Right. Wow. Hey, Brad's got...
More cookies. Yeah, Brian Elton's right there with me.
So Brian, except, yeah, absolutely. Accidents happen. Terry Bowser says, can you please, ask your partners to replace it. Okay, that's nice. Or parents, I'm sorry, parents to replace it.
Hey, there's always broccoli in the fridge.
Oh, that's horrible. I mean, I like broccoli, really, but cookie, oh. Sarah, work it out and don't let them touch any of my things. Ooh, okay.
There you go. Decide they needed it more than me. That was a good one.
Very good. Okay, we got our third question up.
My siblings would not be able to get to my cookies.
Uh-oh. Wow.
Okay, here's another one. A friend gets upset and yells at you.
Ooh, yikes.
That's a tough one.
That is hard. That hurts all the way down to the core.
Yeah.
Walk away and talk about it later.
John Yates, good job.
Yeah.
I'll be sad.
Mark Krause asked why they were upset. Work it out. You know, that could be a deal because they may be upset by something totally different and it just happened to spark it. Yeah, good call.
I saw a whisper, forgive them. Where did that go?
Wow, that's pretty good.
Approach them later. That's a good one.
Yep, let them cool down. That's Hector Gonzalez. Absolutely.
Yeah.
Yeah. Bucky says, yeah, Hannah would walk away. That's good. Like Hannah. Good idea. Give a second.
Maybe talk later. Oh, tell the teacher.
I've got to ask Justin later about what yell I love the lamp means. Or I love lamp.
It's a movie line.
Oh, okay. Sorry.
All right. I won't talk to them anymore. Well, you might have to get around to that a little bit later. Yeah.
I would pray for them. That's a good idea. So yeah, get outside power. Yeah, absolutely. Yeah, exactly. Fantastic.
All right. So here's the big one.
Oh.
Here we go. This one's going to be interesting, dads. See what kind of answer you get from this one. You disobey your parent.
Wow.
I can't hear it. It's too bright in here, says Bill Brown.
Nice. Make it up to them. Okay. Good. All right. I'd never do. Wow. Mm-hmm. My son says that all the time.
I run. Thanks, Andy.
Running. Nice. Write a note saying I'm sorry. Ken Armstrong's kids. That's cool. Nice. Yeah. Ooh, and that's very important. John Barlice, say I'm sorry and learn from it, right? Because that's the important part for mistakes and poor decisions is learning. Yeah, absolutely.
Yeah, Chris Cheever said be sorry and give dad a hug. Dads need hugs.
Yeah, they do. Michael Turpin, admit I disobeyed and do it right away. You know, in the moment makes a real big difference. Yeah.
Mr. Newberry said, and the room goes quiet.
Yeah, right? Darren Reichert, solution says, pay them and get my money back. Laugh out loud. Yeah. Nice. Okay.
All right. Be sorry and not do it again. Woo.
Right.
All right.
These are fantastic. And Hector Gonzalez back with his daughter saying, she says, I'm sorry. I know it takes her a while though.
All right. So moving right along, what is our next thing to do? Now, if you are a member of an All Pro Dad chapter, you can log in to your very own member dashboard. At your local chapter, when you log in, you will have access to your member dashboard. Now, you have a lot of great access to items on there. There's suggestions on how to find subjects that tie back into the topic of the month. So for this month, the other thing that we've added here that I really love is the Father Time Reading Challenge. Now, this is an opportunity for you to look up some books that you can spend time reading with your child. My wife is a first grade teacher, and I hear this all the time, and I know how important this is to read to or be read to every night. It's so important. The Father Time Reading Challenge gives you the opportunity to look for a book, and this time you may want to go to your local libraries when they open back up. You may be able to download them on your Kindle or something like that, some sort of an e-reader or whatever. But these are topics that will tie you back into the topic of the month. Now, every month you get three books at the pre-K 1, 2, 3, and 4, 5 level. So whatever level your kids are. And actually some of the schools, the media specialist is actually separating these books out when we get back in school next school year. I guess they'll be doing that. But one that I want to point out here is if you want to look at in the second and third grade is an author we might be a little familiar with, a couple of authors there, and that is Carson Chooses Forgiveness by Tony and Lauren Dungy. That name may sound a little familiar to you guys. So anyway, so I wanted to talk about the Father Time Reading Challenge. So rolling on out of that, let's see. Keith, I'm going to roll it back to you.
Thanks so much, Keith. I really appreciate that. It's always good to be unmuted, to be sure. So wasn't that a lot of fun, dads and kids? Oh my gosh, y'all are awesome with your great pride moments and cool conversations. And I bet you learned something about each other that you didn't know before tonight. That is exactly what All Pro Dad Chapter is designed to be about, making deeper relationships between dads and kids. Now, y'all know that All Pro Dad actually asks three things of us dads. 1 minute a day. That's 1 minute to read the All Pro Dad Play of the Day. It's a short email that comes to you in your inbox. It'll take longer for you to drink a cup of coffee than it will be to read this thing. And what it does is it talks about things that we deal with as men, we deal with as dads, and we deal with as spouses, if that's our role. It's the nation's number one most read male engagement email. Powerful thing. Definitely for me, helps me keep on my head on straight during challenging times and curveballs like what we're experiencing now. And half the time, I think the writers are reading my mail. I'm like, oh my gosh, this works. Or if it's not, it's somebody that I know that I can pass it on along to. It's a very powerful moment. 1 hour a month, and that is to spend and be a part of your kids' All Pro Dad chapter program in your school. A quick, easy, typically breakfast moment before school starts. Great way to get to know your school, get to know principal and the folks that are working there hard to help with your kids' education, and discover that school is not such a scary place. So we have a place there too. So a really powerful program. And then once a year, if All Pro Dad is having and is hosting an event in your area, an All Pro Dad experience, you never want to miss this. An inexpensive 3 hours of Dad Kid Palooza. Where you just get to go around and create all kinds of fun experiences and tackles and tickles and laughter and pictures and free giveaways. It's just amazing. So you definitely want to be a part of that whenever you can. And the great news, dads, is that it doesn't stop here. You can become a member of your local All Pro Dad chapter and open up a treasury of new tools designed specifically for you to take your role as dads to the next level. So becoming a member of an All Pro Dad chapter is actually free. Like I said, when you become a member, you automatically get signed up for the play of the day, right? You also get a login to your own chapter. And on that page, you'll find all kinds of useful tools like the Bring It Home that has activities and pro tips to truly help you keep your pro level as an all-pro dad, with reading pieces, ways to act it out, all types of communication pieces, and those great books that Keith was talking about. I got to tell you a story about this. In Florida, we had a regional director of a large company who had grown up without his dad reading to him. And so he'd never done it before. He hadn't experienced it. We saw this at his chapter. He took it home. He started doing it. He had four daughters. And he said it has totally changed their family dynamic, totally changed their life. He's got one-on-one time with the girls. Their relationships have never been better. Such a simple thing. And their reading has gone from one level to another. Because dad's investing in it and knows that it's important and they're important to him. Phenomenal, phenomenal thing to do. Also, when you become a member, again, no cost to it at all. You actually can RSVP for the next event at your school. And that way the team captain knows to be prepared for you and your kids and ready for you to be a part of that experience. So definitely something that you want to do. And it's possible that you might not have a chapter in your area, but if so, it's easy to actually learn how to start that. So at the, with the 1300 All Pro Dad chapters that are here, we'd really love you to connect with it. Real easy to find your way to it at allprodadchapters.com. You find the chapter, you join the chapter, and all it asks for is first name, last name, email address, and you create the password. And you're in. And so we're really excited to invite you to that, and so that you'll be a part of that. If you don't hear anything else tonight from us, what I hope you will hear is thank you. Thank you for being a part of this evening. It has meant so much to us, and we hope that it's meant so much to you. At the conclusion of this webinar, you're actually going to be able to fill out a real simple survey so that we know how to what direction to head you in, so that you get the best tools that you need for where you're at, whether that's becoming a member and finding your chapter, or learning more about what it is to be an All-Pro Dad, or learning more about what it is to start and to run an All-Pro Dad chapter. Kids, thank you. Thank you so much for your great answers. Thank you for being here tonight for our first All-Pro Dad chapter online, and we hope you have a fantastic weekend. And dads, thank you so much for loving your families well and making time this evening to invest in them. And for all of us, our thoughts and prayers go out to everyone who is suffering through these challenging times, especially our frontline healthcare workers and first responders. We look forward to everyone's increasing health and expanding freedoms as the globe recovers from this pandemic. But until then, stay safe, stay well, and take care of each other. Thanks so much. Have a great night.